Are you a business owner wanting to use TikTok for your business? Guess what? In today's video, we're talking not only how you can do so, but how you can do so, make videos go viral and get your business more sales. Let's get into it. Hey, what's up? Welcome back to another video. I'm Jessica. If you're new around here, seriously, so grateful you decided to stop by. As you saw, today we are talking about how you as a business owner can leverage TikTok to get your business more sales and how to make videos go viral in the process. But before we get into it, do both you and I a small favor if you're feeling generous and go ahead and hit that subscribe button, because every single week I help you learn how to market your business on all social media platforms to, again, get you more sales, because that's what we're here for. So the first thing that you need to do is obviously make an account. This is super easy. Go to TikTok, sign up. You can either sign up with Facebook, you can do your business Facebook page, or secondly, you can sign up with an email, maybe do your business email. That can be a super easy way. Get it set up. It's pretty simple. Like I said, just create an account and then you're able to start creating content. And that's going to be priority number one, is to create content, obviously. But what type of content do you want to create? My answer, niche specific content. So if you are a business coach, are you creating business coaching content? If you are a laundry service, are you creating laundry service content? If you are a bakery, are you creating content that focuses around pastries and how you make things? These are high level things that you want to start to think about, because you need to put yourself in the view of as if you were the audience member. What would they want to see? Maybe not knowing that you are a business initially, because that's part of the goal. How can you grab people's attention? Say, wow, that was a good video. That's interesting. I want to click on their profile. And then they see, oh, you're a business. You offer products, you offer services. Let me click more, find out more, maybe watch more of your content. And then that's when they start to fall in love with you. And that process of the like, know, and trust factors kick in, and they eventually buy from you. And that's a super condensed version, of course, right? But guess what? That's exactly how you do so. So what we need to focus on is creating niche specific content. Start brainstorming things that your audience wants to see. Are there tips? Are there tricks? Are there behind the scenes? Are there myths that you want to debunk? Are there other categories within that realm that you can use to leverage in showing your audience and them saying, yes, I want to learn more. I want to go to your page, or I want to click that follow button so we can see more of your content. This is going to be really helpful to start getting more views on more of your content even later down the line. So the second thing that I want you to do is, when you start creating this content, are you using viral or trending songs? This is going to be huge. This is almost just as important as hashtags, which, spoiler alert, we're talking about next, because there's a certain way that you should be using those as well. But using trending songs is another way that your videos get tagged. TikTok's algorithm works that when you click on a song, you can go in and see all the videos that were created under that song. The key is to catch the song trend early so that you can hop on the bandwagon and get near the top of the trending as soon as possible and for as long as possible. So how do you identify trending songs? Go in and look at new songs or sounds that are taking place just through your For You page. Which ones are being used a lot? That's a good question to ask yourself. Maybe use those. And can you kind of keep note, if you do some watching in yourself, which ones are growing? So maybe you see a song that only has 50,000 uses, but the next 2 or 3 days later, it goes up to 100,000, 200,000. That's potentially a new trend starting. So can you create a piece of content using that song or sound that's going to tag your video and get people interested in seeing more of that sooner? So that's gonna be tip number two. Use trending songs and work really hard to identify trending songs and sounds. So tip number three is to use hashtags. If you are not using hashtags, or more specifically, not using niche specific hashtags, you are doing so much more harm than good in growing your account, because without the tag, guess what? People aren't going to be able to find you. If people can't find you, what the hell are you even doing using it, right? So how can you be using hashtags? Which one should you be using? Let's answer that right now. First things first, can you use hashtags that are specific to your niche? Again, just as you're creating content that's specific to your niche and staying within that, I want you to do the same with the hashtags. Because what this is gonna do is this is going to attract your correct audience. It's going to make sense that if you are a mommy blogger and you use a mommy blogger hashtag, hashtag mom for life, other moms who are on the platform will start to see more and more of that content, because content is curated directly for you. That's how their algorithm works, which is amazing. And you'll fall under that category and land directly in front of, like the example, a mom. So when you can stay within your category and yes, continue using niche specific hashtags throughout all of your content, TikTok is gonna start categorizing you in the best way possible and saying, we're gonna put you more in front of the people who want to see your category of things, whether it's baking, whether it's online coaching, whether it is blogging, dancing, funny videos, whatever it might be, stick to your category. So how many hashtags should you be using? 3 to 5. You have the opportunity to use a ton, but let's keep it simple and let's stick with 3 to 5 within our caption. The second question to this is, should you be using hashtag for you page? No, you really don't need to be, because guess what? Anything can hop on your for you page as content starts to get more curated specifically to you based off of these categories, right? So focus on spending your hashtags on things like niche specific related material or content, and forgo the simple hashtag FYP or the hashtag for you page, whatever it might be. One last tip I want to give you regarding this is to make sure that you are sticking within the small to medium sized hashtags. Using some in the millions or less is way better than using the billions, because again, it's going to be very difficult for your content to show up if it's competing against, I don't know, like a billion other videos, right? So the final tip that I have for you is to be as consistent as possible. If you want to post once a day, do that. Twice a day, do that. 3 times a day, do that. However, whatever you do, do it as consistently as you can, because TikTok is going to see that and they are going to favor your account over one that maybe isn't being quite as consistent. So if you love this video, do yourself a favor and again, hit that subscribe button, because I have videos coming out every single week that'll help get your brand more visible on your favorite social media platforms. I am signing off for now, and I will catch you on the flip side.